Ahmed Johnson walks up to the steps to get ready for business, Bret Hart will be on Raw this Monday night on the USA Network, and I'm sure that Bret will have a lot to say. And Shawn will be there too. Ahmed Johnson paying his respects to the late Brian Pillman, who unexpectedly and unfortunately passed away last Sunday. And Ahmed Johnson, who has had his share of personal problems as well, including a lacerated kidney, a injured knee, and now an injured hand, most of that brought on by the Nation of Domination. And now Ahmed inviting Big Jason Arndt just to slap the Pearl River Powerhouse right in the face.
And I don't know whether this is some kind of motivational tactic by Ahmed Johnson, but I've never seen this one before. He's just asking the guy to smack him right in the mouth.
Ahmed Johnson is a very complex, a very intense athlete. And now Ahmed's taking off his protective knee brace
and hands it to Arndt and says, what's his hit? And Arndt clocks him, and down goes Ahmed.
Ahmed invited Jason Arndt to strike him in the face with that knee brace. If Ahmed's looking for a wake-up call, the alarm clock is going off.
Well, you say complex, I say nuts. I think he's crazy. Wait a minute. Here goes Johnson.
Ahmed Johnson getting up ahead of Swiggy.
Look out. Here they come. Hey, JR, I'm out of here.
Sit back down.
I'm out of here. I'm not going to let some psychopath come out here, tear furniture up around my ears.
Sit down and do your job. This one might not last that much longer. Ahmed Johnson. Oh, there's a version of the Michinoco driver. And Ahmed Johnson just dropped Jason Arndt right on his head. And we know what kind of damage that can do. Remember SummerSlam, East Rutherford, New Jersey, when Owen Hart dropped Stone Cold on his head. And this crowd loves this carnage.
And wait a minute. There's the big spine buster. That's the same move that Farouk injured Ken Shamrock with. Gave him lung injuries. He's been popping up blood. Ahmed Johnson is going for high-risk moves, high impact, that hurt people.
I'm not so sure the referee, Tim White, shouldn't stop this matchup. I don't think Arndt can even defend himself here.
Well, I think it's going to be a moot point if he lands this Pearl River plunge.
Boom! There it is. That should be all.
Two fingers.
Ahmed Johnson finally puts Jason Arndt out of his misery.
You couldn't have paid Arndt to kick out if he could.
And Ahmed Johnson is intense. He is a very, very aggressive human being with a very storied childhood, a very angry human being, and I wouldn't want to be in the shoes of the Nation of Domination.
It looks like he's hurt that hand again, but this guy is almost indestructible. He gets injured, but he comes back stronger.
Wait a minute. Not again. Ahmed Johnson is trying to break this kid apart. And there's another Pearl River plunge. That's too much.
Now look at these people. They're egging him on. They're calling for it.
Wait a minute.
It's a bunch of sick, sadistic people just like the New York fans.
Oh, stop.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has reversed the decision. The winner of this bout, Jason Arndt.
Well, the referee makes maybe in the eyes of some, a controversial call, but it's the right call. Took a lot of guts by Tim White to step in there and stop this carnage.
And what else did Ahmed Johnson expect?
Come on.
Now, look at this.
Not one more time, no.
And listen to the people. They want to see him break this kid in half.
Ahmed Johnson is out of control. And here's a whole contingent of striped shirts led by senior referee Earl Hebner. And Ahmed Johnson may find himself suspended or fined for these actions.
I think I did hear the word fine come out of Hebner's mouth, and they're dragging Jason Arndt out like a sack of beef.
A very emotional Ahmed Johnson. He is too intense. Ahmed Johnson is going to hurt somebody sooner than later.
He's got some personal problems, I'll guarantee you that. But I'll guarantee you that when we come back, it's the interrogator and the jackal of the Truth Commission taking on the Disciples of Apocalypse.
And still to come, a tribute to a superstar whose life was cut too short, Brian Pillman.